In this video, I'll carry out the following arithmetic operations to the correct number of significant figures. And sometimes people call it significant digits as well, because we're looking at the number of digits in these numbers. Now, when you are adding or subtracting, the only thing you really need to look at is the number of digits after the decimal point. And you just keep the lowest number of digits after you add. So you add all of the numbers. So you add 45.7 plus 30.08. And adding those, you would get 75.78 meters. And then after the fact, you look and you see, I have got the lowest number of digits after the decimal place is 1. We have 2 digits after the decimal point in this number, in the 30.08, but just 1 in 45.7. So we have to limit this then to just 1 digit. We are 1 digit after the decimal point. We're not going to just truncate. We're not just going to make it 75.7. We have to round correctly there. And so that becomes 75.8 meters. We're rounding correctly. And in that case, rounding up. All right. In multiplication and division, as with the next two examples, there's a little bit more to think about. So I'm going to run through a couple of the rules. And in the easiest way is just to list some numbers and then just show how many significant digits. So I'll just write a little table there. Significant digits or significant figures. Okay, so if I have a number like this, 0.003, there's only one significant digit there, because all of the zeros before a non-zero number don't matter. Now, on the other hand, if I have 8.003, now I have 4 significant digits, because we have to consider all of these numbers, because we have this non-zero number. And then any zeros in between, or sandwiched between non-zero numbers, do count. So you have to count all of those. Okay, what about this one? 4.0. How many significant digits? We have 2. Every zero, every single zero after the decimal point, if you have a number greater than 1, I should say, then those count. So like these zeros didn't count because there was no non-zero number in front of them. But this number is greater than 1. So we have to count the 4 and the 0. So there are 2 significant digits or significant figures in this number. Let's go on to another example. How about 8.5 times 10 to the 6th? Are there 6 significant digits? No. There are 2. 2 significant digits. Just the 8 and the 5, so 2 significant digits or significant figures there. Okay, let's take a look at this. And I'm going to rewrite this specifically to test your knowledge of the significant digits. So let's rewrite the 3.98 times 10 to the negative 3rd in its native form, 0.00398 newtons, multiplied by 9.0 times 10 to the 4th. So that's 9,000 meters. Now, if we were to multiply that, well, before we multiply, let's look at this. We have 3 significant digits, and here you're thinking, the way it's written here, you're saying, well, maybe it's just 1 significant digit. And that's because if you have 120, this will come up in this example, if it's not specified, any zero that does not come after the decimal point, and there's no decimal point, let's say there's no decimal point, then we don't include the zero as a significant digit. So we could just say 2. However, we clearly specify the decimal point in the scientific notation. So that's a way out. of trying to determine whether or not we have significant, how many significant digits. So if I were to write this as one, let's back up. If I were to write this as 1.2 times 10 to the second, that's still two significant digits. However, if I were to write this as 1.20 times 10 to the second power, now we're talking about three significant digits. So we specifically wrote that decimal point in there to show that we have the significant digits. Okay, and that's what we did here. So this has, in conclusion, it says two significant digits or significant figures. Okay, so when we multiply this, what you get is 358.2 Newton meters. And that's a measure of torque or moment. Now, we could write this as 360 Newton meters. And when you don't specify the decimal, then you can just kind of assume those are the two significant digits. Notice I've just rounded correctly. Or I could write this as 3.6 times 10 to the second power Newton meters. And you'll see that scientific notation come up a lot, specifically to show we are limiting this to two significant digits, and that's what you're doing when you multiply or divide. You limit it to the lowest number of significant digits. So not just the number of decimal places, but all the significant digits. So for example, this has two significant digits. So we limited this to two significant digits. Okay, on to this next one. Now, I kind of gave you a little precursor here. The 3.012 grams divided by 120 cubic centimeters, this has four significant digits. The 3.012, that zero does count. And then 120 cubic centimeters. Now, we can't assume that this zero is significant. Without a decimal, we can't assume it. So we're just going to say this has two significant digits. So we're going to limit this to two significant digits. So this comes to, when you multiply this, this comes to 0.0251. We're going to round this to two significant digits, so we could write this as 0.025. That is two significant digits. I better put a label on this. That is grams per cubic centimeters. Or we can write this as 2.5 times 10 to the negative 2 grams per cubic centimeter. And this is a measure of density. That's not a very dense substance, whatever that is. If you found this video helpful, consider liking it or sharing it with a friend.